skin, pink Banish.
Hey, it's me, Sam, aka Vegan Acne Sufferers. Today's video is a hot tamale topic, which is vegan acne. Be sure to stay tuned through to the end of the video because I'm going to be asking a question. And if you leave a comment with your answer below, then you'll be entered into a draw for a chance to win a Banish Kit. I love it when people message me and tell me that they're thinking about going vegan. I love it. Not only are they making an improvement in their own lives, in terms of their improving their health if they're choosing to eat more whole foods, but they're also helping the environment and they're helping the animals. But sometimes these messages follow up with another message, and I get this lengthy, long-winded message being like, Sam, I went vegan based on your recommendation and I'm loving it, but my skin is freaking out. I've tried X, Y, and Z, I've used these products, I've cut this out of my diet, started adding more of this in, and nothing's worked. What do I do? I always get a little bit nervous when I get these messages because, you know, acne shouldn't stand in the way of doing what's right, and acne is something that can be treated. Honestly though, most of the people I talk with fall head over heels in love with veganism, the lifestyle of being vegan, and so they're completely on board with treating it the vegan way or treating it using alternative methods other than reverting back to meat and dairy, because those aren't the answer. Why acne occurs at all, why we have acne, is an answer that generally eludes us. We know why acne forms, you know, there's inflammation, there's oil, there's bacteria, but there are literally so many factors that could go into forming acne and different types of acne, and exactly why it forms will never be known precisely. However, we can still get to some of the major or root causes for some people. Even if you are seemingly doing everything right for your skin, you may still get acne. And this is true of people both vegan and non-vegan. I had terrible skin before I went vegan. And everyone who's ever had acne knows that even when we've got it all together in our lives, our skin sometimes has other ideas. But what about people who've never had acne before, or people who just suddenly broke out after having clear skin right after going vegan? What if that's the only thing that's changed in your life, is you've gone vegan and now suddenly you're breaking out? What are you supposed to do? What if there's no other explanation? Ah, but what if there is? One of the first things you need to do is take a good, long, hard look at the things you've changed in your diet, the things you've changed a little bit, the things you've changed a lot of. And these are going to help you determine, you know, what kind of things might be influencing your acne breakout. For example, a lot of us cut out dairy from our diets. I had a lot of cheese and dairy in my diet before going vegan, and so that elimination alone can affect your hormones. Dairy is a major source of exogenous hormones, hormones that we put into our bodies that can affect the other hormones in our bodies. Unlike plant hormones, these mammalian hormones have a direct effect on our body. It's very measurable. And so when we eliminate that, you know, that could throw off the balance of hormones in our body, at least temporarily. Or if you've suddenly started eating a really healthy diet, a diet rich in fiber and fresh fruits and vegetables, you know, maybe that could be an explanation. For example, maybe your gut bacteria just aren't up to the job. Maybe you're not eating enough of something. Are you hitting all of your macronutrient targets? Are you getting adequate fat and carbs and protein for your lifestyle, for your age, for your gender? Are you getting enough zinc? Are you getting enough iron? Are you getting too much B12? Things like too much or too little of a vitamin have been shown to result in facial eruptions. Or maybe you went the other way when you went vegan and you became more of a junk food vegan. You learned of all the yummy, accidentally vegan foods like Oreos, and so you started stocking up on them and eating a lot of garbage. This might be a more obvious sign of a cause for these breakouts. I know that when I eat like garbage, it shows on my face no matter what. And so that's definitely a cause. If you've switched to eating a lot more processed foods, maybe you ate a lot of meat before and you've been supplementing it with more faux meats, vegan meats, which are processed just as much as regular meat is, but it's a different processing. So if your diet has suddenly shifted even maybe to eating more breads or more high glycemic foods, you know, that shift alone could cause an increase in acne. on top of this, we have to just expect that any diet change, no matter how big or small, is likely to bring about some side effects, whether undesirable or desirable. The fact is, we each have a very specific gut microbiome that is unique to us. And that microbiome is fine-tuned to our diet and the diets we ate growing up. So whether we had a very meat and potatoes type diet before, and whether or not we had a very plant-based diet before, will really affect how our skin reacts. Doing things like keeping your diet as diverse as possible, eating lots of different fresh fruits and vegetables, legumes, nuts and seeds, and even supplementing with a probiotic could help if the gut bacteria are the root cause of your acne. However, there is some question as to whether or not the gut microbiome is capable of adapting measurably and sustainably to dietary changes, which just means that although we take probiotics and things to improve the diversity of our gut microbiome, sometimes these things are more set in stone than we would like to believe. And if the gut bacteria and the dietary change are clashing, then it's possible that there may not be a source of relief to the acne in the sense that taking a probiotic would help. Another thing to look at is whether or not you've started eating a lot of foods that you didn't eat before. I know that there are a lot more foods now that I never used to eat. Mushrooms, bell peppers, spicy things. I didn't eat a lot of that before, and while those aren't typically allergens, sometimes people, you know, load up on strawberries and load up on nuts because they're a great source of protein and energy, but they don't realize that maybe they were sensitive to them before, or maybe they've developed an allergy over time, and so allergies can sometimes mimic the appearance of acne. Allergy testing is a good idea, and if you don't want to go that route, if it's something you have to pay for and can't afford or don't have access to, then an elimination diet is a good idea. Looking at the potential common allergens in your diet or the foods you've shifted and focused more primarily on, having a period where you eliminate those from your diet can help you determine if that's a cause. And another thing I think we often overlook is not just checking in with the dietary change that comes with veganism, but if you are a vegan, a true to the word vegan, somebody who's doing it for the ethical implications, not a environmental vegan necessarily, but even an environmental vegan, you know, there are ethical implications that weigh quite heavily on us. And so I think it's important to ask yourself when you're experiencing a breakout, you know, maybe it didn't happen suddenly, maybe it happened a couple of months after you went vegan, or it's progressively gotten worse, where are your stress levels at? You know, how are you handling this transition emotionally and psychologically? I know that when I went vegan, it weighed very heavily on me, and it still does to this day weigh heavily on me. I've learned to manage it better, but at the beginning, it was definitely a big shock, I guess you could say, to the system. During times of high stress and anxiety or depression, we can definitely experience facial breakouts. There is an entire acne category, I believe it's called a variant of pyoderma, that young women sometimes get when they are experiencing high stress. And it's a temporary condition, usually, but it's quite severe, and it's very much acne. And so we know that this high stress, high anxiety can lead to acne, yet we overlook sometimes that in going vegan and opening our hearts up and being vulnerable to the reality of the world can sometimes cause a lot of anxiety. And so maybe it's possible that your vegan acne might be caused by some emotional distress. Maybe at the words of non-vegans, or maybe just at the mere knowledge of the injustice that's happening. Even if none of these work for you, and even if you've tried these methods, there's still so much we don't know about skincare and diet and how the body works together to create disease. But don't worry, because there are amazing vegan skincare products out there that can help do the grunt work. You know, you can work on improving your diet, and you can work on, you know, finding the root cause of your acne. Maybe it's hormonal, maybe it's just elusive, and it's something that you're stuck with. And that's when you turn to your skincare routine. You can definitely still be a hero to the animals and have clear skin. So I know a lot of people have foods that they avoid because it worsens their skin. Vegans excluding dairy and stuff like that is obvious, but some people exclude things like grains or nuts and seeds if they have allergies, like I mentioned. I would be interested in knowing what kinds of foods you've eliminated from your diet for your own personal reasons that you think have improved your acne. So what kind of foods, maybe a citrus food that aggravates your skin? It's sugar for me, definitely sugar for me. When I eat too much junk food for too many days in a row, and I'm not eating enough fiber, not drinking enough water, all of those things come into play, but sugar or high glycemic, you know, pastries and stuff like that, those are definitely the worst for my skin. So let me know what yours is below in the comments section, and you might be picked. You might win a Banish Kit. So definitely leave me a comment below. I'd like to hear some of your ideas, and it might give other people ideas on what they can try to eliminate from their diet that might be a potential source of acne breakouts. Thank you guys again for watching. I hope you found this video useful. If you have questions, comments, suggestions, leave them in the comment section below and I will do my best to get to them. Have a wonderful day and I will see you next time. There's a hope this way.